associera till vad vi skapat och till vad
So the question is he's asking about the Big Bang. Many people say that the world came out of the Big Bang. Can you give some?
Yes, the brother wanted to give some enlightenment on the topics of Big Bang theory. We know in 1973 there were a couple of scientists who did a very thorough research about this subject, that how this universe came into existence. So they give certain formulas that there was a Big Bang. Initially this world, the earth, the planets, the sky, it was together, and then somehow it took long periods to come this world to come exist, the sun, the moon, the star, the planet, the Mars, and everything. So this is what the scientific terms they describe as Big Bang. So if you go back to the Quran, you know, Albert Einstein in 1925 he got the Nobel Prize for inventing this theory of relativity. But he also says in one of his lecture that religion without science is blind, and science without religion is lame, is nothing. When we analyze these issues about science and religion, believe me, the Quran is not a book of science, which the scientists described, S-C-I-E-N-C-E, science. But this book is a book of sign, S-I-G-N-S, signs of miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So among his miracle, he also described this theory that was discovered in 1973 by the scientists in the last century, about these things, what they call Big Bang. But the main theory was that this primary nebula, the earth and the planet, the sky, the heavens, it was together and somehow it comes into a split. So the Quran says in 21st chapter, Surah Al-Anbiya chapter 21 verse 30, very simple message and addressed and focused especially to the unbeliever. Allah the Almighty says, أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Do not the unbelievers see, أَنَّ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ, the heaven and the earth were joined together, كَانَ تَرَكْتَنْ فَفَتَّقْنَهُمَا, it is we who have clothed them asunder. So the sign says there was some force initially to make these things into happen. Some force. They don't know which force, because we cannot go back to the time to prove everything. Science has a limit. So science says somebody makes some force. Who is this someone? What is the force and how it was? So the Quran gives the answer. That do not you see the unbeliever? Who is the unbeliever? Are the unbelievers of 1400 years before in the Makkah? Definitely the answer will be no, because it was discovered recently. So now the Quran is talking. Allah knows. He gives challenge on time. And this is the eternal challenge. Eternal challenge. Till the doomsday, till the day of resurrection. So this challenge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is valid till today when it is discovered. Now the Quran is challenging the scientists that don't you see this was, you discovered it recently, 30 years before, 40 years before. It was together. Who clothed this asunder? Allah says it is we clothed them asunder. We make it interpretation and we make these things come into existence. And professor like Stephen Hawking in Canada, in Toronto University, you may know he is a very famous scientist. He is a stunner and he is disabled to speak or something, but he is one of the great, most recent scholar on that field. He wrote a book, A Brief History of Time in his book. He said this is one of the biggest discovery about the bridges, about this Big Bang theory that was discovered in the last century. And if we just closely analyze these scientific aspects given in the Quran and explained by the scientists, we may rationally ask them questions that what was the force, who made the force, how this force was there, and why you said this was 6 period, why not 7 period, 8 period, 9 period? So Quran gives the answer in Surah Yunus chapter 10 verse 3 and Surah Araf chapter 7 verse 54, that it was 6 periods, long periods, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this heaven and the earth, and the mountains are in between. So this is the Big Bang theory in a nutshell, in a very nutshell. Quran also indicates another verse in Surah Fusilat, Surah Shura, chapter 42, verse 11, that this earth and the sky, initially it was like smoke, flame, like a smoke. And Allah says to the heavens and the earth, be they are joined together either willingly or unwillingly. And they reply that we follow the willing obedience, and they come together. So if you ask a scientist that you say it was gaseous, initially the heaven and the earth was gaseous, but the Quran says it was a smoke. So the scientist will say smoke is much more higher preferable than mere gas. Gas, it has many particles, but smoke is more appropriate to use the word smoke. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows how He created this universe. What was the condition before the creation of human, before the creation of others?